All right. Oh no. This needs to be up a little bit. All right, we're good. All right, so what is up and what is glorious? YouTube, the World Wide Web, as you guys can see in live HD, it's your host with the most, Paul Cantu. Yeah, with a brand new customization video. So you guys know I love turning trash into treasure and breathing new life into beat up sneakers and thrifted apparel. So recently I was in the thrift store and I came across the what are those? Really beat up Jordan Trailblazer 3s. So these things are absolutely disgusting.
Ew.
And they are definitely jacked up. So there's a lot of damage going on everywhere. They have stains, they have beat up leather regions, the suede is completely distressed. However, I figured these are still a great canvas to actually use as a sneaker customization. So my inspiration behind customizing these shoes is derived from one of two places. The first of which is this awesome vintage Dale Earnhardt Sr. tee.
You ain't first, you're last.
I just love the colors, the blue and this gradient of like yellow to orange to red that's going on with the hits of purple and black. And to go with that color scheme, I also found this vintage snapback right here. It is blank, it is like Fresh Prince of Bel Air vibes.
Act like you got this tick, right?
With this crazy like 90s pattern. So I'm gonna go ahead and actually apply this type of pattern, this colorway, all onto the shoes so I can build a fantastic custom thrift fit with my own two hands. Without further ado, let's get into it. Lego.
All right, children. So first and foremost, getting into this tutorial, I had to look at these True Blue 3s to evaluate how deceased they were upon purchase. And these things are dead as hell. So what do I gotta do? I gotta clean these guys. So the first thing I did was rip out all of the laces. These guys are way past their prime, so they're going straight in the dumpster. I'm sorry. Once the laces were gone, I got out some Rejuvenator deodorizing spray. The fine folks at Rejuvenator did bless my ass with hella stuff, including shoe trees, which really do help reduce the creasing and give me a nice work surface to do this customization on. Now, they also sent me a lighter, which was very convenient for burning all the loose threads, an expandable bowl, and some Rejuvenator sneaker solution. Advanced kind, so I squeezed that into the bowl, got a nice all-purpose brush that I also was blessed with, and I scrubbed down the shoe in its entirety. So this is my first time actually using their product, and I must say, the brush and soap combo goes hard. It cleans both suede and leather simultaneously. Extremely rare, extremely clean. I just wiped all that down, and if you guys would like to help me keep the lights on and bless yourself with some shoe cleaning supplies, check out Rejuvenator, use code ThriftGod to make your shoes look as good as these. So at this point, I could have just restored the shoes, but I'm going for the full custom. So what I had to do, I had to strip down that clear coat of protective paint that lays atop the Poltergeist white Jordan frame. I also did the outsole and midsole, had to scrape with a screwdriver and my fingernails to remove all the paint. But once that paint was out the way, these midsoles were ready to be painted. But before I did that, I had to dye the suede. So I got out the black to turn the elephant print a very rare, exotic, and erotic black color. So we got the black elephant in this bitch and then the cocaine midsole as well. So I got out that leather paint and just painted the midsole to give myself a nice base to actually add some color onto next. So the color I chose was this magenta pink, and I really wanted a dip dye gradient effect going all throughout the midsole. So I laid down the pink first and foremost, then it's time to whip out that codeine dream, baby. And then I started blurring the two together, really trying to create that gradient just with a paintbrush. A lot of people use airbrushes. Bro, I got that stroke game vicious in this thing. Ask your mother about me. I just went in, blended all the colors, had to add about 3 to 4 coats of paint before the blend was absolutely flawless. Flawless is how I see it and how I call it, baby. Just look at this, from pink to purple, effortlessly. Then I got the back tabs with the flat black paint, and that was looking perfectionate as well. Now's the time to go crazy and get artistic, not autistic in this thing. Hey, but shout out everybody with autism, you dig? So I added the yellow, then I added the orange next, and I basically was just freestyling all of these designs I started with the light color, worked my way up to orange, and then red, and then eventually you guys will see me actually painting the blue. Now, I did like to blend a few of the colors, creating nice gradients all throughout the design, because I felt like some hard contrast with some blending of the colors would look absolutely gorgeous. So I added some pink, then this light teal looking blue. Oh my god. Once the blue was added, I really had faith that this custom would come along gloriously. And it did. So once I added the light blue, I hit some dark blue on as the next color choice. And that color actually did fill in very, very nicely. And I decided to hit it with a nice little like 10-piece color combo. Even though it might be 8, I don't know how to count. But yeah, right here you got the blue. You got the reds, the oranges, the yellows. Then I added some perp to tie in the midsole with the upper of the shoe. Now the purple took many coats to actually lay down and solidify the color, really to enhance it and make it vibrant. So yeah, dude, if you guys are going to customize the shoe, you have to lay down minimum 3 coats of paint. So each individual section I had to paint over basically 4 times for it to look like this. So once the purple was done, I had to add the black tag as well to tie in, of course, the elephant print and the little back tab that I previously painted. So I got out a thin, fine little brush and added crazy details with the black. So basically, I rinsed, washed, and repeated on the tongue and the toe cap, but I did want to go around and conform my brush strokes and design to the shape of the panels of the shoe. So the toe cap had a lot of round lines. The tongue also has some cool gradients and some horizontal lines going all throughout. And of course, after the pink, red, orange, I added the light little Carolina tealish blue. I honestly mixed these colors to make each one unique, and I love the way it came out. And just as I did with the outside, man, I blended some dark blue in with the light blue to create a flawless gradient once again. And that basically is all there is to it when I was riding in a Buick doing this. Now, I'm not gonna lie, this process was so tedious, frustrating, but paid off. Just know that, daddy. So I added some more black details, little lightning bolts, other things just to create a nice interesting vibe all throughout. And then when attacking the tongue, I painted the Jumpman all white, that way the colors I laid down after would pop off his little bitch ass. So I added some golden yellow dehydrated piss colorway, a nice sunset going on the tip of the tongue, some oceanic waves, and then I hit the Jumpman with more gold to make him really stand out. I surrounded him with black as well, that way the outline would really pop the Jumpman off the tongue. Now the inside of the shoe, it did need to be painted black in certain areas that remained white, so I hit those with some dark saturated color. And there you go, baby. Yeah, y'all thought I was done. No, I wasn't. I have to do the inside as well. So it's the same process, but here's the inside actually complete of the shoe. And then I had to hit the Jumpman on the back with some light blue as well. And I wanted to make him fun and funky in regards to lettering, so I had yellow, orange, and red on the back. And then it was time to move on to the second shoe. I hit that with a ton of yellow, a lot of that orange, and some more red, baby. So once you do one shoe, man, it almost is the hardest part, just coming over the hill and completing the second shoe. But of course, I want to rock and shock these. These are for myself. So I went ahead and completed the second shoe, which was an arduous process. This is hands down one of the most time consuming customs I've ever done. So if you guys enjoy this, man, please like the video and show some love, because it was a lot of effort. Look at the Jumpman too, got that fireball. But here's the second shoe done. And last and not least, I just added the laces onto my custom kicks. I chose black, of course, to complete the colorway, and I thought it looked great. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, here are these shoes done in their entirety. And don't ever forget where these shoes came from, because these were some beat thrifted J's, and now they are complete. Without further ado, peep what these look like on feet in these streets. Let's get it.
living a bloody life, I rooster. And I'm in it to win it, so I'm somebody that you should get used to.